Okay, finally. So the Saku head had been pink already. So it's time to combine it with the light up the circle. What if I just light up the head? Okay, let's go. Okay, let's do it. First, probably need to attach this one. Actually, maybe not. I'm not sure. Alright, should be this section first. I've been paint the clear part, as you can see right here, the clear red or whatever. They used to be clear color. Because just like somehow I put it as display without light up, they should have the effect for that. Like so. Okay. And then they got two different type of the top part. And then for this I did like this touch up, so make it like more details on it. I'm gonna put that one first. Let's see how it goes. So, and then for those it's pretty loose. That should be like that. Maybe I got it wrong. Try it the other way around. Oh, this side is correct. Should be like this side, I think. So the other one, because they got the print at the front already, both of the side have been break. So I'm not sure this side is right or not. It's very confused. Yeah, it looks like that. Let me put this on and let's see, do they light up? Oh yeah, they do already light up, because they light up by the magnet. So I use the blue tag to stable the magnet. You can see it's pretty bright, and this is like 1/100 scale. And you see the label here, because I use it for the z-gundam. So just don't worry about the labels. They do have other base on the base for the head. I probably need to repaint another base for him. Alright. Pretty happy with the finish. You can see I did some engrave some pen line on it. Get more details, but I didn't do any multi-color of the green, otherwise it could be looks better. In the back part right here I put metallic gray, and then before I spray the matte finish, just use the masking tape cover it, so make it like a different tone. Let's swap the other one, let's see how it goes. Alright, let's put the other one on it. The really basic cool. Okay. Yeah, that one still looks cool. Okay, let's leave it there. There's the way how I need to make the circle head because I want to do something different, but I'm not sure it's really work or not. Yep, that is the one. Maybe I try to put the circle head on the z-gundam. Let's see how it goes. Alright, the z-gundam are in front of me, by the way. I pretty much found out the z-gundam may not be the right size what I got. All because this z-gundam is not the Master Grey. This is from one of the China brand. I forgot what was it. I still haven't done a review for this yet. But this is like a transformation. It's full transformation. Pretty much like the Master Grey z-gundam. Of course, they do have the die cast joint. Alright. What I put the 100 scale Saku head beside it is like huge difference. Maybe I try to hold the camera to show you guys closer. That is the size. If you like one size bigger, you can see that. But no matter what, I just need to try to put it on. Have to look. As you can see right now, the z-gundam head have been popped out, so I can have a closer look for this. You'll see the size compressing. But I can't really remember for the animation. Are they the Saku head is really like huge different size or not? I'm pretty sure the third party which is make the z-gundam, the head is like much smaller than Master Grey. Yay. Maybe I use that one. Oh, maybe I got the other one. Let's see how it goes. Alright, just beside me, you will see that is the actual 1100 Master Grey. Version 1, you will see the difference. Much smaller. Anyway, let's back to the Saku head. Let's see when the Saku head leave it on the z-gundam, what would that be? Oh my god. Doesn't really work, man. Look at that. They're pretty much like the SD Gundam hat on that. This project is foul. It's not really fit that set Gundam. No way. Oh, maybe I need to purchase 1100 Saku and use this head instead. Look at that. Maybe I'll get some blue tag, extend the neck joint. Let's see, is that better or not? Okay, here we go. I put the blue tag extended, but the result's still not good enough. Okay, put a wide angle, let's see. It's not really work on it. The Bandai 1100 circle head is still huge. Like, too big on it. Anyway, today's up to here. Thanks for watching. See ya.